What are you doing?
Stretching. Getting ready for the gymnastics today.
You're an idiot. Go put on some spandex. Hi, welcome to Evention. I'm Jimmy Schramm, and today we're going to show you how to set up a simple gymnastics exercise for your horse.
Jimmy, what color is spandex?
Let's get started.
G'day. All jokes aside, gymnastic exercises are a very useful tool when training jumping horses. They have many uses. They help the horse to use his muscles and develop his technique, and they're also very useful in helping riders look at problems in their position. Today we're going to be looking at a very simple three-part gymnastic exercise that just about anyone can set up at home. Now, in order to set this up, you're going to need three things. Some rails, a few of them, about 12 foot wide is normally the general width of show jumping rails. Some standards and cups. Or, if you don't have fancy standards with cups, you can always use a good old chemical drum. Now, comes with two built-in heights, full height or half height. And this is a very useful, easy tool that you could probably pick up at the local hardware store. And you can buy half a dozen of these and set up quite a course with them. So, here we are at the first element of our simple three-part gymnastic grid. I just got some trot poles set up out here. You're gonna need at least four rails, and you want it far enough back that it's not quite related to the next part of the grid. Now, a good starting point for your trot poles as far as distance in between them is about one good human footstep. Now, you can also try it this way, four foot lengths. Now, depending on the size of your horse and the size of his stride, this distance could vary greatly. Obviously, a Shetland pony and a Clydesdale are going to do this exercise quite differently, so please be prepared to adjust this depending on the horse and how big his stride is. So, this takes us on to our next part of our grid. Perfect. This brings us to the second element of our grid, the bounce. Now, bounce is great because it gets the horse thinking about what he's jumping. He doesn't take a stride in here. Instead, when his front feet touch down, followed by his back feet, he's already leaving the ground to jump the second part. The distance between the two elements of a bounce is about 9 feet, which equates roughly to about three big human steps. One, two, three. Now, obviously, if you've got real short legs, you're probably gonna have to take bigger steps than that. And if you're in doubt, just pull out the tape measure just to be certain. This brings us to the final part of our grid, a little one-stride combination up to a small vertical. Now, hopefully by now, the first two aspects of our grid have gotten the horse thinking about what he's doing. I've got him stretching his neck, pricking his ears, thinking about what's going on, so that when he gets to the final vertical, he can make a nice spascule, a nice shape over the fence. Now, the distance between a one stride is anywhere from 18 to 24 feet. 24 feet being a full competition distance, 18 feet being more of a small schooling distance in a grid such as this. Now, because the jumps aren't very big and because we're not coming in very fast, we really need to make it slightly shorter because he's not going to be jumping in really big here. So pull out your tape measure just to make sure, and hopefully we're going to have a great exercise that's going to help supple our horses and improve our position. I've got Tex here with me to help me out and see if my grid works the way I want it to. I'm just going to come around in a nice steady trot, let him think about what he's doing, and let the grid do the work for me. Perfect. Testing, testing, one, two, three. G'day, Eventioners. G'day, my little Evention enthusiasts. Eventionistas?